Hello, my name is Mahmut Yurt. I'm a PhD student in the Department of Electrical Engineering at Stanford University. Here I will be presenting our work for the CS236 Deep Generative Model course. The title of our work is Can DDPMs Beat GANs on Conditional Medical Image Synthesis? Multimodal medical imaging provides complementary diagnostic information about a given anatomical structure. This information is presented in the form of multiple images acquired under distinct contrast using different scanners or sequences. However, prolonged acquisitions and increased scan costs limit acquiring some of the contrast. A promising solution against this limitation is to generate missing modality images from available source modality images. For instance, given that T1 weighted imaging requires 5 minutes and T2 weighted imaging requires 10 minutes, one can decrease the scan durations by 10 minutes if T2 weighted images are synthesized from T1 weighted images. In this study, we comparatively demonstrated conditional denoising diffusion probabilistic models against conditional generative adversarial networks for medical image synthesis. In principle, medical image synthesis can be seen as an image-to-image translation problem, which is widely investigated in the computer vision domain. The goal is to synthesize a target modality image given a source modality image. This can be formulated as gx goes to y, where x is the source modality image and y is the target modality image. GAN models are predominantly used in the domain, and actually pixel-to-pixel and cycle GAN models are well investigated for these tasks. On the other hand, DDPM models are newer methods that are not demonstrated for medical imaging yet. In fact, conditional versions of DDPM models are also very rare in the computer vision domain.
We adopt conditional DDPMs as our main approach and two GANs, namely pix2pix and cyclogan, as our baselines to compare. In the conditional DDPM approach, the forward chain from step 0 to step t consists of adding Gaussian noise with a certain variance and coefficient to a given image y0. For training our DDPM in this setting, we use algorithm 1, which is given here. So in this algorithm, we input our network at each step x, y, and gamma, which are respectively the source modality image, the target modality image, and the noise schedule. So as the noise schedule, we follow the inspiration on other works and use a uniform distribution. And for the loss function, we use the L1 difference between networks and also the function's output and the added noise. So for inference in our network, on the other hand, we need to go from the reverse direction from yt all the way to y0. For doing that, we need to rely on the posterior calculations and network's current estimates of y0 in the posteriors. So we, for the inference in our network, use the given algorithm 2 in t iterative refinement steps. So as also seen in the figure below, the algorithm, our network at each iterative refinement step refines the image quality, and we use the as the last our last estimate of the target modality image, the y0, which is obtained at the t-th iterative step here. And also for the baseline methods to compare, we implemented the pix2pix and cyclogan methods, both of which are conditional GANs. So the pix2pix methods has the given loss function here, which is based on an adversarial loss and a pixel-wise loss added to it to improve the network's image quality. And the cyclogan has the given cyclic loss here, which allows to perform the synthesis task both ways.
We performed our demonstrations on the AXI dataset that is publicly available. The AXI dataset contains T1 and T2 weighted brain MRI images. As their combinations, we consider two synthesis tasks. One is to synthesize T2 weighted images from T1 weighted images, and the other one is to synthesize T1 weighted images from T2 weighted images. Here we first visualize the reverse denoising process of our model, where 2000 time steps are performed to do this process. As can be seen, the DDPM model gradually removes the noise and it generates a target domain image that is conditioned by a source domain image. Here it can be seen that this conditioning enables the DDPM model to preserve structural information of the image because these should come from the same patients. We then compared our DDPM model against pixel-to-pixel cycle GAN models. Representative images are displayed here. It can be seen that these results from the methods under comparison are very similar, with small PSN and SSM differences. Please note that the duration of the generation is much less for the pixel-to-pixel cycle GAN models, as they perform a single-shot processing, whereas the inference time for the DDPM model is elevated due to its iterative nature. In this study, we demonstrated conditional GANs and DDPMs for medical image synthesis. GANs yield high-quality image generation and they are very strong, but DDPMs also yield accurate synthesis. We believe that the hyperparameter and code optimizations can help improve DDPMs performance. Please also note that DDPMs might not be well suited for the task that considers shortened inference processes.